The NRZ and LSU have had a landlord-tenant relationship that dates back to 2005, when LSU moved from NUST campus. The two entities have now decided to expand their relationship in order to include collaborations that strengthen each other's business competitiveness through innovation and entrepreneurship activities. The new focus on devolution in the country requires that regions embark on smart specialization in order to drive regional growth and competitiveness. This requires regions to identify their local strengths in terms of activities within existing sectors and industries, and the companies that drive these activities. Innovation and entrepreneurship are considered the main drivers of regional growth and competitiveness. For the southern region of Zimbabwe, the rail transport sector, the timber and furniture industries, the beef and leather industries, the gold sector, the energy sector, and the tourism and hospitality sectors are the main drivers of our competitiveness in the region. Today we are gathered, ladies and gentlemen, together to sign an MOU whose envisaged activities are geared towards the actualization of an integrated system of passenger and goods transportation, which is designed to better meet the needs of passengers and industry and commerce park transport needs, in line with the nation's vision of becoming a middle-income country by 2030. Some of the activities that are envisaged under the MOU are: one, the development of an integrated system for the automation of business and administrative procedures for the rail transport sector. Two, research in the field of health and safety of production processes within the rail transport sector. Three, the development of production standards, scheduling of passengers and goods trains, and the development of standard time norms. Four, the improving of the delivery of strategies to prevent rail accidents and driver fatigue. One of our press members was asking in relation to the rail accidents. Automated control systems for rail transport, development of pricing models in the rail transport sector, improving the skills matrix or ecosystem of the rail transport industry, and many more activities that shall follow once the MOU is in operation. The envisaged activities shall involve all of the faculties within the university, and we are hopeful that the outcome would be a more robust and competitive rail sector in Zimbabwe. The proposed activities are in tandem with the new Education 5.0 philosophy by the Minister of Higher and Tertiary Education, Innovation, Science and Technology Development, in which the production of goods and services is a key factor or cog in the higher and tertiary education ecosystem. We are hopeful, ladies and gentlemen, that with time, the National Railways of Zimbabwe shall establish a processing entity within the University's Innovation and Industrial Park in order to grow Lupane into a major town and for import substitution of key components in the rail sector. With these few words, I thank you.